The United States Agency for International Development, USAID, has distributed 235 pieces of critical medical equipment to support 36 health facilities across 21 districts in Uganda. This equipment, which focuses on improving maternal and child health services, is expected to save and improve countless lives. The medical devices include ultrasound scans, hematology analyzers, microscopes, infant incubators, radiant warmers, delivery beds, and oxygen concentrators, among others. While receiving the equipment on behalf of the Ministry of Health at joint medical stores in Zambia, Dr. Daniel Lechabayinze, the Director of Public Health, said that the donation was timely and pledged to put it to proper use.
Ministry of Health is pledging to be accountable. To be accountable in terms of our actions, accountable in terms of our resources, but also to be self-leadership oriented. That we shall audit and continue to audit every maternal death. For every mother we lose in this country, we must say, what did we do? What was preventable?
During the event, U.S. Ambassador to Uganda, Ambassador William Pope, highlighted the importance of capacity building, like training health workers, alongside equipping health facilities.
It's going to benefit 36 hospitals, private and public hospitals across Uganda. This is equipment that is going to help prevent maternal and child deaths.
The USAID contribution is part of the United States government's continued commitment to strengthening Uganda's healthcare system, particularly in rural and underserved areas. The government has urged schools to ensure strict adherence to standard operating procedures SOPs on the prevention, detection, and control of mpox in schools to avoid exacerbating the problem in the country. Heads of schools currently undertaking the Uganda National Examinations Board UNEP examinations are particularly urged to take extra care by using the provision of clean water and soap or hand sanitizers to maintain hygiene and prevent the spread of the disease. UNEP spokesperson Jennifer Kalule Musamba today said that schools should ensure that publicly used surfaces like desks are sanitized as regularly as possible. She made the call during the joint weekly security briefing while giving an update on the ongoing national examinations that kicked off recently across the country, where a total of 379,748 candidates for both new and old curriculum examinations are writing exams at 4,168 centers.
The school should ensure there's clean washing water as well as soap or sanitizer outside examination rooms, and also they need to ensure that they do clean the tables as regularly as possible, which are used by all the people like when doing the examination.
The World Food Programme's Executive Director, Cindy McCain, has called on the warring parties in Sudan's conflict to grant full access to the agency as the country faces the imminent threat of famine. She warned that the whole of Sudan currently at famine alert level and famine already declared at Darfur's Zamzam camp.
The goal today was to first of all meet the leadership, because I had not met them yet, and to reiterate to them the need for us to have complete and unfettered access, as well as the ability to get in through as many different entry points into Sudan as possible, and to make sure that we can begin to feed at scale. You know, famine's alert right now, and famine's in Zamzam camp, and it will spread. So it's really urgent that we get in and that we can do it at scale.
Sudan has been gripped by war since April 2023 between the regular armed forces led by the country's de facto leader Abdel Fattah al-Burhan and the paramilitary rapid support forces RSF led by his former deputy Mohamed Hamdan Daglo. The conflict has killed tens of thousands of people, displaced millions, and resulted in one of the world's worst humanitarian crises. Both sides have been accused of committing war crimes, including targeting civilians and preventing aid from reaching those in need, as well as using methods that amount to starving millions.